students, welcome to Biology Revart. Myself Om Prakash Khatre, and today we are discussing class 10th biology section, control and coordination chapter, topic reflex action. Students, there are two type of action. One action depends on our will, it is called the voluntary action, and another action which is not depend on our will, it is involuntary action. Here we will discuss reflex action, and it is also involuntary action. So what is reflex action? The reflex action is very rapid action, very quick action. It is automatic action, spontaneous action, which responses in which will is not involved. It means such type of action, which is quick action, automatic action, involuntary action, which is not depend on our wills, and this action is called the reflex action. So main site of reflex action is controlled by the spinal cord. So simply we can say the spinal cord control the reflex action. What is reflex action? Question is asked. So reflex action is a quick action, rapid action. It is automatic, spontaneous responses in which will is not involved. Will is not involved. It means it does not work according to our will. So it is involuntary action, and this action is controlled by spinal cord. In our central nervous system, CNS system, we have the two parts. One is called the brain and another part is the spinal cord. So brain is responsible for the control of voluntary action, and spinal cord is responsible or controller of the involuntary action. So reflex action is controlled by spinal cord, or it is regulated by spinal cord. Such type of number of action we are performing, and this type of action example such as when sunlight come, we are closing the eyelids. So when sunlights come, then closing up eyelids or closing up eye is one example of reflex action. Another example is jerk in legs. So if long time we are sitting on one place, then jerk come in the legs, that is also reflex action. Another example, sneezing and coughing. If any foreign particle enters in our nostril region, that sensitivity, it is also reflex action, coughing and sneezing. Another is yawning. When lactic acid is accumulated, in that time the laziness comes, and that is also laziness is action of reflex action. When we are watching our delicious foods or favorite food, then saliva secreted in the mouth. So secretion of the saliva, sweating occurs when you will see your favorite food item, that is also reflex action. Milk secreted by lactational mother. Lactational mother also automatically a baby cries, then the milk is secreted, that is also the reflex action. One common example which is given in our book is withdrawal of hand from flame or needle. If you are keeping your finger on the needle and you are touching the hot object, in such time you are withdrawing your hand immediately, and that action is also reflex action. So reflex action example and two example you must remember. Another, the reflex action is regulated by a small unit, and that unit of reflex action is called the reflex arc. So reflex arcs we are defining a unit of reflex action. whatever activities are done, that is unit for the reflection is reflex arc. What are the component of the reflex arc now? This reflex arc is the unit of reflection, is having receptor organ, sensory organ, nerve, spinal cord, motor nerve and effector organ. So these are the five parts in reflex arc. Receptor organ, as I told you, these organs are receiving the stimuli. They are receiving the stimuli. So receptor organ are receiving the stimuli. Stimuli may be heat, it may be cold, it may be chemical, it may be gravity, it may be water. So it is received. So these organ of reflex are called receptor organ. So receive the stimuli and eyes, ear, nose, tongue and skin, these are the sense organ. So in the this sense organ, this receptor located. Another is sensory nerve. This nerve conducts the impulses from receptor to spinal cord. So they carry the information or nerve impulses from receptor to spinal cord. These nerves are called sensory nerve. And one more in name is here, afferent nerve. These are also called the afferent nerve. But you must remember sensory nerve. They conduct the impulses from receptor to spinal cord. Third part is spinal cord. Spinal cord is part of central nervous system, as I told you, and it acts as a modulator. It is a modulator. In this case, the impulse change, sensory change sensory nerve into the motor nerve. So impulses are changed from sensory nerve to motor nerve. Whatever impulses, whatever information coming sensory nerve, that changes into the motor nerve. So change sensory nerve to motor nerve, and that is function of spinal cord. Next part is motor nerve. It conducts the impulses from spinal cord to the effector organ. This one conducts the information from spinal cord. Motor nerve, what is the function? It's conduct the impulses from spinal cord to the effector organ. And this effector organ, it means they may be the muscles. Another part is effector organ. This organ give responses to stimuli. It means give responses to stimuli like the muscle. So this receptor organ, sensory nerve, spinal cord, motor nerve and effector organ, these are the five components of the reflex arc. Now, how do this action occur? This action is occur. Here you can see, I am having the one example, hot water is in the beaker. And if you are touching this hot water with the finger. So, this finger, there is a skin. Skin is act as the receptor. Sensitivity, we get the sensitivity by the skin. So, skin is a here receptor. So, this receptor organ is a skin. Now, from this receptor organ, this sensory nerve carries the information from skin and it's bring into the spinal cord. This part is called the spinal cord. So, sensory nerve, what is the function? It brings the information, receive the stimuli and then sensory nerve conduct the impulses from the receptor to spinal cord. So, this nerve is called the sensory nerve and this brings the information to spinal cord. When information comes in the spinal cord, that nerve impulse and nerve information of the sensory nerve is changed into the motor nerve. It means there is another neuron which is called the connector neuron. This change the information of sensory nerve to information of motor nerve. So this is called connector neuron. So first one, receptor organ. From receptor, the information is brought to spinal cord through the sensory nerve. When information comes in spinal cord, now sensory nerve information is changed by the connector neuron, and now through the connector neuron, this information goes through the motor nerve. It means motor nerve, it carry the information, it conduct the information from spinal cord to the effector organ. And here effector organ is a muscle. So this is the pathway where the impulses pass. Stimuli. When stimuli come, it's carried by the sensory nerve. The sensory nerve send the information to spinal cord. From spinal cord, the information goes to the motor nerve, and then from motor nerve, it goes to the effector organ. So how is the reflex action occur? Understand. If we are touching with the finger, if we are touching the hot water with our finger, then hotness is sensed by the skin. So hotness of the water is received by the skin. Skin is a receptor of it. And this information is sent to the spinal cord through the sensory nerve. In spinal cord, information is interchanged. And this information of the spinal cord now change sent to effector through the motor nerve. So through motor nerve, the information goes to the effector organ, and here effector organ is muscle. So the muscle get contract, and once the muscle get contract, we are withdrawing our hand. So this process is rapid process. It's an autonomous process, automatic process. It takes the very less second of the timing, and this action is a involuntary action. So now what is the importance of this reflex action, or what are the uses of reflex action, and we are discussing now significance of the reflex action. Reflex action, it enables the body to quick response to the harmful stimuli. If any response comes, so our reflex system, it's enabled our body to quick response to the harmful stimuli. Such as if light comes, immediately we are closing our eyelid. It's enabled the body of organism to quick response to the harmful stimuli. Another important is it prevents overloading of the brain. As I told to you, brain is a thinking part of our body. So if spinal cord is regulate the involuntary action, then what happens? It prevents the overloading of the brain. So it prevents its fatigue. So spinal cord, it gives some rest to the brain also. And third important is more efficient for the quick responses. So this reflex arc makes the body more efficient for the quick responses. So thus, what is reflex action? Example of reflex action, unit of reflex action, which is reflex arc, component of the reflex action like receptor organ, sensory nerve, spinal cord, motor nerve and effector organ, their function, and it is mechanism and pathway how the reflex action works. Thank you.